Hey guys, in this lesson, I'm going to cover Amazon DynamoDB. So what is DynamoDB? This is AWS's database. They created this completely themselves. And DynamoDB is a fully managed NoSQL database service. So it's a non-relational database. It's not a structured SQL type of database. It can store key value and document data types, and it's fully serverless. It provides push button scaling. That literally means you can go in and change some settings and provision more performance so you can scale your database without any downtime whatsoever. In DynamoDB, we have tables. So the database is created by AWS, and within the database, we create tables. Those tables are spread across partitions, which are replicated across multiple AZs in a region. So you can think of DynamoDB as a database that scales horizontally rather than vertically. DynamoDB provides very low latency in the region of milliseconds. Microsecond latency can be achieved with something called DynamoDB Accelerator, DAX. So be wary of that in exam questions. If you see milliseconds, DynamoDB, if they mention microseconds, then we might need to put this caching layer in front, which is DAX. All data is stored on solid-state drive storage for high performance, and it's replicated across multiple availability zones within a region. We can also have global tables, which synchronizes tables across regions. And the interesting thing about this is it's multi-master. So that means that you can actually make updates to the database in different regions, and those changes will be replicated. And it's asynchronous replication between regions. So let's have a look at some of the features of DynamoDB. It's fully managed and fault tolerant. It's highly available with 4 nines availability SLA and 5 nines for global tables. It's a NoSQL type of database with name value structure. It provides a flexible schema. That's good for when your data is not well structured or unpredictable. So you might not want to use a relational database. It provides horizontal scaling, and there is automatic scaling as well. Another feature is called DynamoDB Streams. What happens here is whenever you make updates to items within the database, and think of items as being the rows in your database, so the data that you're actually adding. If you update that data by deleting, adding, modifying, what happens is a record of that transaction, that modification or addition, is actually added to a stream where it can be picked up by other services. So for example, Lambda can then read those updates from the stream and process that information in some way. If you want to, for example, make sure that every time an item is deleted, some kind of record of that is stored externally somewhere. That would just be one use case. DAX is the in-memory cache for DynamoDB that I mentioned before, will increase performance by reducing latency down to microseconds. We have options for transactions, so updates to the table. We can have strongly consistent or eventually consistent reads and support for ACID transactions as well. For backup, there's point-in-time recovery down to the second within the last 35 days, and there's on-demand backup and restore as well. And then global tables is the fully managed multi-region, multi-master solution for when we want to have our database spread across multiple regions and be able to make updates in those different regions. So what are the core components of DynamoDB? Firstly, we have tables. So we get to create tables within the DynamoDB database service. Within the tables, we then have items. Think of items as the individual entries in the table. And then we have attributes. So the attributes are associated to each record. So as you can see here, for example, user 002 would be one of the items in the table, and the attributes are the actual values that are associated with that key. Remember, this is a key value store. So the key in this case would be the user ID for this particular table, and the value or values would be the attributes that are associated with that particular key. DynamoDB is, of course, an API-driven service, so everything that we do in DynamoDB can be performed through the API. API operations are categorized as control plane or data plane operations. A few examples of control plane API actions would be creating the table, describing the table, so returning information about the configuration settings of the table, listing all your tables, updating tables, and deleting tables. Data plane API actions can be performed using party SQL or classic DynamoDB create, read, update, delete CRUD APIs. Let's have a look at some example data plane API actions. Put item is writing a single item to a table, whereas batch write item is writing up to 25 items to a table, so that's more efficient. Get item retrieves a single item from the table, and batch get item retrieves up to 100 items from one or more tables. Update item modifies one or more attributes in an item, and delete item will delete the item from the table. DynamoDB supports several data types, and they can be categorized as scalar, which means numbers, strings, binaries, boolean, null, for example, document types, so for example, JSON documents, and set types that represent multiple scalar values, such as string set or number set or binary set. In DynamoDB, we have some options for different classes of tables. Standard is the default and recommended for most workloads. We've got standard infrequent access, which means lower cost storage for tables that store infrequently accessed data, such as application logs, old social media posts, and e-commerce order history, or past gaming achievements for a gaming application. For access control, all authentication and access control is managed using IAM. DynamoDB supports identity-based policies for attaching permissions policies to users or groups in your account to supply permissions. You can attach a permissions policy to a role as well to grant cross-account permissions. Also, DynamoDB supports resource-based policies for tables, indexes, and streams. So you can specify access for specific principles to perform actions on those DynamoDB resources. And the maximum size of a resource-based policy attached to a DynamoDB resource is 20 kilobytes. The primary resources in DynamoDB are tables, but also there are indexes and streams as well. You can create indexes and streams in the context of an existing DynamoDB table, and they become sub-resources. And those have unique ARNs associated with them, such as this. So we can apply access control to these different resources. By way of example, this policy will grant permissions for one DynamoDB action. So here we have the allow effect, the action DynamoDB list tables, and the resource is any. But of course, rather than using a wildcard for the resource, we could specify a particular resource that's relevant to this API action list tables. The following example policy will grant permissions for three DynamoDB actions. So here we've got describe table, query, and scan. And for the resource, we have specified the specific table, which in this case is called books. In this example, the actions are restricted to the specified resource, the DynamoDB table.